What's happening out there, everyone? It's Roll Easy here, and I'm back very quickly with another solo money glitch video. Seems like these facility glitches are becoming unpatched. Like, for the most part, we have found a bunch of stuff, old stuff that is working again. This solo money glitch is found by Tuto Facile France, and it's pretty easy, but it's not the most consistent. But I did hit it very quickly compared to the last time I had to do this. And guess what? I got the footage first on PS4 and next on Xbox, okay? So it's a dual console video to show you guys how to hit this glitch. All right, so what you're gonna need is, this is found by Tuto Facile France, by the way. You need a full facility. Fill it up with any cars you want, any cars at all. Then you want a garage, a separate garage, full of RH8s, okay? Just fill it up to the brink with RH8s. Set your spawn location to that garage. Then get a retro custom and have it in another garage or whatever Benny's vehicle, not the facility. So you see this garage right here, Eclipse Penthouse Suite 1. I have a bunch of RH8s in there. I will be overriding those, okay? And I also recommend a public session. For some reason, the times that I hit it, it was only in public sessions. If I started in an invite only, I don't know, it just didn't really work. It's not laggy enough, I believe, something like that. But you see my spawn location? It's set to Eclipse Penthouse Towers Suite 1, okay? That's where I have all the RH8s in. So set your spawn location to there. Get a retro from a different garage that's not that one. Or the one, I think it can be in the one with the RH8s. Mine was in a different one, just to show you guys that it works. But yeah, you're gonna see right now, okay? So head over to your facility when you have your retro custom ready to go, or Benny's vehicle. Oh, and you need custom plates. Very important. Sorry, I forgot to mention that. Put a custom plate on this car. You do need custom plates for this glitch, or you will make dirty dupes, okay? So I'm going to show you how to do it on PlayStation. I think a recent activity, remember, PlayStation first, Xbox is the second half of the video. But PlayStation, I think your best bet is using a recent. To me, recents work really well with PlayStation. You should take advantage of them because you have them, okay? So on PlayStation, I'm going to get a recent ready, and I'm going to be hovering over Star GT Online. So as you can see right here, I'm going to double tap the PS button. I'm going to go up to my facility. Well, first I'm going to show you. Yeah, I needed to check my spawn location. It's set to that garage with the RH8s. I'm going to just do a quick game save right here by selecting my outfit and make sure the bottom has an orange save icon. There we go. So I know I'm going to be spawning in that garage. So now I'm going to go ahead and take my retro custom with a custom plate on it, get the facility full alert, accept it, and quickly, all right? So accept it, wait maybe a second or two, double tap the PS button, start GT Online, and go ahead and, you know, do it like that. Now, I think that's actually a little bit too quick, okay? And you're gonna see what I mean right now. So all you gotta do is accept the actual, you know, the actual recent activity, okay? You're just literally going into a new session after accepting the full alert. But you're gonna see right here that I actually do fail. What you wanna see happen is you spawn in the garage and you wanna have, excuse me, you wanna have the vehicle management menu up, okay? So you can replace a car. But as you can see right here, I'm gonna spawn in, and look, I'm not gonna have any sort of vehicle management, you know, selection menu, nothing like that, okay, if I ever spawn into this garage. There we go. So you see, look, I didn't spawn in with the vehicle management menu, so that means it didn't work, okay? But luckily, it's pretty easy to just reset up for this glitch. Now, for the video purposes, I'm gonna go ahead and just grab one of these retros out of here that has a custom plate and needs a custom plate on this car, guys. The glitch works without a custom plate. You can go ahead and try it without a custom plate, but you're gonna make dirty dupes, and you go to sell those, you're gonna be dupe detected. Okay, I had some people saying glitches still work without custom plates. Yeah, they work. Doesn't mean you're not gonna get dupe detected, okay? You wanna have custom plates for this. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this retro, and I'm actually gonna put this retro in a different garage, okay, to kind of prove to you that it did actually dupe, all right? So I'm gonna just go ahead and pull around right here, and I'm gonna drive this, I think, into Eclipse Penthouse Suite 3. Yeah, I'm gonna put it into this one right here. Okay, I have like RH8s in here as well, so I'm just gonna kind of transfer them, all right? So this is just for video purposes, just like, as you know, like proof, okay? So I'm gonna swap it with this one. So remember, right here in slot 5, this is the retro that we're actually using, but we're spawning in that other garage that's filled with RH8s, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and drive this out, and I'm actually gonna drive this over to my facility, okay? So this is the tough part. I recommend probably having a garage closer to your facility, because, you know, you're gonna have to drive now over to the facility to restart for the glitch, but that's all good. So get the facility full alert, and look at this time. I'm gonna wait till the animation starts, then double tap the PS button, hit Star GT Online, and accept that recent activity, okay? You wanna accept it and go into the new session. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just talk while this is loading right here, but this glitch was never very consistent. It took me about 3 hours, I remember, when it first came out to actually hit it on Xbox, and it was terrible. For some reason, I just couldn't do it. On here, within 30 minutes, I got the footage on PlayStation and I got the footage on Xbox. So I don't know if I got lucky or not, but it seems to be a little bit more consistent this time around, okay? The facility has gone through a lot more patches, so maybe that affects it in some way. But I'm telling you, I hit it way quicker. I had maybe 2 fails. The first time, you know, my first attempt on each console, I failed. But the second attempt on both consoles, I hit it. All right, so you're going to see right here, this is still on PS4. Xbox is the second half of the video. I'm going to be spawning in. And you're going to see I'm going to be spawning in with the vehicle management selection menu. Okay? And when you have a vehicle management selection menu, you're just going to replace over one of those RH8s that's in that garage. Okay, so you're gonna see right here in a few seconds, boom, look at that. See, I got the vehicle management selection menu. So just go ahead and replace over an RH8 and check it out. There you go, you literally just made a dupe, as simple as that. It's saved, ready to go, all right? And just to prove to you guys once again, I'm gonna go ahead and exit the garage and I'm gonna show you the other garage with the original retro that we were using, okay? So I'm pretty sure you could use a retro from this garage. I think that is totally fine. But for the video purposes, I wanted it to be in a different garage just to show you guys, okay? So I'm gonna walk out of here, Eclipse Penthouse Suite 1, and I'm gonna go into the Suite 3, okay, where that original retro was. So you see Suite 3, I'm gonna walk in here, and we should see that same LG Retro Custom in slot 5, all right? This is the one that has a few modded cars in it and stuff. So you see that? This is my original, the dupe is in the other garage. So as you can see, it clearly did dupe successfully, all right? So go ahead, guys, and do this. That's how I recommend doing it on PS4. Use the recents. We got them on there. You can load up that thing pretty quickly. You know, same timing every time if you find a good rhythm. All right. But now we're going to jump over to Xbox. Okay. So on Xbox, I have the Route 68, you know, garage. So as you can see, proof right there, I'm on Xbox. I have a Route 68 garage. I set my spawn location to there, and this is actually a retro from my special vehicle warehouse. So if you have one in there, you can call that up. No mechanic, no nothing like that, okay? So you're gonna see right here, I have it set to my Route 68 garage. That one is full with 2 cars I wanna overwrite. I'm gonna get the facility fuller, press pause really quickly, go to online and find new session. Now, for some reason, I kind of like lost, you know, I kind of lost my way there, and I went too far to the right past the online tab. That's okay. I mean, I do fail on this attempt right here, but I think I was just a tad too late. All right. Just I took my time on that one and I was just a little bit too late. And you're going to see I'm going to spawn in this garage right here. You see, and this garage is literally right across the street from the facility. So if you have a facility with a garage nearby, I recommend using that. Nice and quick to get reset up for the glitch. Okay, very, very quick. So I'm gonna be spawning in here momentarily. Once I spawn in here, look, no vehicle management selection menu. But I'm gonna be overriding these two, like, you know, bared down ugly retros that I don't really want. They only sell for 500 grand. So I'm gonna replace it with a more expensive retro, which is the one I'm using. So no vehicle management selection menu. Look how fast it takes me to get reset up to do this glitch when you have a vehicle, or when you have a retro in your special vehicle warehouse from back in the day. Okay, so I'm just gonna run over to the street, and I realize right here when I'm gonna go select the car that I'm not close enough to a street. You see, you are too far from a suitable road. So I gotta run a little bit closer to the road. But once I'm there, I can easily and quickly, every time I go into the new session, I can just request this retro again, since it's from my special vehicle warehouse with no cooldown. So you see, it actually is classified as my Ruiner 2000. All right, so once I grab this vehicle, I'm just gonna get reset up to do the glitch. So here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and just grab it. And yeah, like I said, you can have your retro in another, in that same garage, I believe. I didn't test it, but I remember people saying that that was totally fine. I never did it that way, but you can go ahead and test it out, see if it works for you. So I have my retro, I'm ready set up to do the glitch. You see that? It took me, what, a minute to reset up and do it? So I'm gonna go ahead and accept the facility fuller, pause online, find new session. So you see, I was a lot more fluid and quick on that one. And on this one, I should actually get the, you know, the vehicle management selection menu when I spawn into the garage. So I'm just gonna fast forward a little bit through this loading screen right here. But you see, this is 100% solo. PS4 can do both methods because you have recents and you have the pause menu, obviously. Xbox, I definitely recommend just using the pause menu. Some people join friends, but, you know, joining fully into a friend, I don't really recommend it. The alerts don't come in very well, and I know a bunch of you guys are going to scream it's not solo, all right? Even though you can add people all the time randomly till they add you back. But anyways, this one is 100% solo, these two methods. I'm going to spawn into my garage and check this out. I will have the vehicle management selection menu when I spawn in here. All right. So here we go. Boom. Look at that. So now just pick a car to replace over. So I'm going to replace over one of those ugly retros that I have over there and check it out. Boom. There's my dupe, guys. Nice and simple, all right? So this is a super easy solo money glitch. Not the most consistent sometimes, but as you can see, I got the video footage for this on two consoles super quick, all right? So if I had the luck, you can definitely have the same luck, all right? But yeah, that's going to be it for me, guys. Make sure you have custom plates for this glitch. That's very, very important. My name is Roll Easy. Please subscribe to the channel if you're brand new by hitting that big red button. Turn on post notifications and drop a fat like on this video and the rest of my videos for the freshest and the most informative dope GTA 5 online content. Road to 25,000 subscribers. Peace out, guys.